हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट टेबल्स इन वर्ड 2016. स्टूडेंट्स, जनरली वी यूज एमएस एक्सेल टू स्टोर डेटा इन टेबलर फॉर्म एंड फॉर कैलकुलेशंस, बट वी रिक्वायर टू स्टोर डेटा इन वर्ड आल्सो. वी कैन यूज टेबल्स टू रिप्रेजेंट अवर डेटा इन अ मीनिंगफुल वे. इन वर्ड द ओनली डिफरेंस इज वी कैन नॉट कैलकुलेट. In this chapter, we will surf about table, inserting a table, entering data in a table, selecting rows or column, inserting rows or column, deleting rows, column and table, merging cells, splitting a cell, formatting a cell. What is a table? A table is an arrangement of data in vertical columns and horizontal rows, forming a cell where they join together. Columns are the vertical section of the table, whereas the rows are the horizontal section of the table. You can insert a table using graphic grids. In Word 2016, you can insert table by following given steps. Just click on Insert tab, then table, or visually select the size of table. Size of table means you can select the number of rows and columns according to your requirement. Using insert table, this option lets you insert a table by selecting number of rows and columns. To insert the table, follow the given step. Just click on insert tab. Click on table drop down arrow in the table group, then click on insert table option, then enter the number of columns and rows you want in table, and at last click on OK. The table appears in the document. Now using quick table, this option lets you insert built-in table template in the document. Templates are the pre-formatted design files in a software or a program. These tables are the types of table which are commonly used for calendar, list of things, etc. To insert a quick table, follow these steps. Click on Insert tab, click on Table drop down arrow in the table group, then select Quick table from drop down menu, then select the table template according to your choice. To enter data in a table, follow this step. Just click in the cell and start typing. To move the next cell, press the tab key. That's it. And selecting rows or column, after inserting a table, you can select any row, column or a cell for other function. To select a row, click in the row selection area of the row you want to select. The row gets selected. And to select a column, hover your mouse in the column selection area at the top of a column. The mouse pointer changes to a downward pointing arrow, then click on the column to select it. Selecting adjacent cell, to select the adjacent cell, click in a cell and drag through the row or column. Students, you can insert rows or column in a table from table tool. To insert rows or column in a table, follow the given steps. Just click on Layout tab in Table tool. Select a row or column where you want to add an additional row or column or cell. In the row and column group, click the desired option. You have insert column to the left, insert column to the right. You can insert rows above or rows below. Or you can insert cell also. Deleting rows and column. To delete rows and column or cell from a table, you can follow these steps. Just select the row, column or cell which you want to delete from the table. Click on Layout tab under the Table tool. In the row and column group, click on Delete command. We can delete an existing table by click anywhere in the table. and then click on layout tab under the table tool. Then click on delete command and select delete table. You can merge two or more cells in a table to create one large cell. This is used frequently to merge the columns of the top row to create the title of the table, or you can merge cells row wise or column wise. To merge cells of a table, just follow these steps. Select the cell that you want to merge. Click on layout under the table tab. Then click on merge cell command in the merge group. Then cell get merged. After merging the cell, sometimes the content of the cell get mixed up. You can easily change the layout and fix it later. Splitting cells. You can easily split a cell into multiple cells. To split a cell, follow the given steps. Place the mouse pointer inside the cell to be split. Then click on layout tab under the table tool. Then click on split cell command in merge group and enter the desired number for column into the number of column box and number of into the number of rows into the number of rows box. Then click on OK. You can divide a cell into many cells, row wise or column wise or both. To make your table more attractive, you can apply styles to your table by clicking anywhere in the table. Then click on design tab under the table tool. Then click on desired style in the table style group. We can change the row height by the following step. Just select the row, click on layout, and then go to the table row height in cell size group. Change the height of row in the height scroll bar. You can also change the column width. We can change the column width by following steps. Just select the column, click on layout tab, and then go to the table column width in cell size group. Then change the width of column in width scroll box. You can change the text alignment also. Select the cell or cells, click on layout tab, then go to the alignment option in alignment group. And select the alignment you want to apply to your text, right? So useful links are also provided on some of the slides to enable you to watch the videos and learn. Students, these slides are practice oriented and you have to repeat these steps for practice. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.